welcome to our Maunday Thursday service. It's going to be here in my study so we can reflect together on what it meant for the disciples to gather with Jesus on that night, that Thursday night before Good Friday, before the crucifixion, and just remember what that meal meant. And so you will want to have bread and cup, and also maybe access to an order of service, but most of the stuff will be also available on the screen. And so we begin with our call to worship. The Lord be with you, and also with you. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let's exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, delivered me from all my fears. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him. Let us pray. God our Father, we have gathered here to celebrate and share the supper which your only Son left to his church. As we keep the feast of his redeeming love, may we feed on him by faith, receive his grace, and find the fullness of love and life. Loving God, you taught us compassion. You took a servant's role and knelt at the feet of your friends. You gave us a meal to remind us of your life-giving love. You called us to love one another too. Forgive us, Lord, for not practicing the compassion you modeled. Forgive us, Lord, for wanting to be served rather than to serve. Forgive us, Lord, for not loving as you called us to love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our scripture reading comes from Mark chapter 14. As we continue our journey in Mark, Mark 14, beginning at verse 12, and going to verse 26. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and make the preparation for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large upstairs room, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there." So disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as Jesus had told them. They prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came with the 12. And when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Be better for that one to never have been born." While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it in the kingdom of God." When they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. A text we know well. A text we've heard read many times, probably. A text we remember on this night, on Maunday Thursday. Two things of background are useful to know as we look at this text and think about it. First, what was Passover all about? Passover was that moment when the people of Israel had been saved from their slavery in Egypt, having been captured and controlled and working as slaves in Egypt. They were freed, set free. The Passover lamb was sacrificed, the blood put on the doorposts, and ultimately they were freed, set free to become a people, a nation, God's people. And so this celebration, this Passover meal, was a celebration, somber and serious, but a celebration. Good news, joyful news. The other thing that we should not miss is that in the Passover celebration, at the very beginning, the very first one, the people of Israel had their meals together in family groups. And if they were in a family group that was not large enough to eat a whole lamb, they were to invite the neighbors to join them. So two or three households, depending on how small they might be or how large they might be, would join together to finish off the meat on the lamb. So this is a family celebration. And Jesus has it with his followers, with his disciples. And so the first thing to notice here is that Jesus is creating a new family. He's been doing that all through Mark. A couple of times in devotional material, we've highlighted that fact that Jesus is building a new family, a family of his followers, a family of those who eat and drink with him, who eat and drink this meal with him. They are his new family. He makes them one. So they're eating the Passover, and Jesus certainly changes the mood of celebration when he says, "And one of you will betray me." Talk about a downer. One of you will betray me. And they all wonder if it's them. Is it I, they ask? Am I the one? Surely not I. He's confronted them all. And he has reminded them that this celebration, that this moment of celebrating, this moment of talking together and remembering the Passover is going to take on a new dimension, going to take on new reality because of the cross. And so this meal is eaten in the reality within the shadow of the tension, of the opposition, of the critique, of the criticism, of the conflicts that have been taking on all week, that have been going on throughout Jesus' life. Now the moment is coming, the hour is arriving when a showdown will take place. And so this meal is celebrated against that background of fear and uncertainty, of coming in secretly, of coming to this moment. And Jesus then says, this bread and this cup. This is not new. He's adding to what already existed. He's adding to the Passover meal. Because for the people of Israel, for the Jews at that time, the Passover wasn't a mere remembrance. It wasn't just remembering back to an event a long time ago. In fact, they understood that the Passover made them free right now, that their freedom as a people was based on what God had done in the Passover. And so, yes, it had taken place a long time ago, the first Passover, but it was alive and living and dynamic in their lives right now. They're experiencing it right now. And Jesus takes that truth and says to us who are about to celebrate this meal, this is not just a remembering of something that happened nearly 2,000 years ago. No, in this meal, I come to meet you. In this meal, I come to be with you. In this meal, you are set free from all that holds you, all those things that enslave you. Yes, sin. We're freed from sin, and when that cross certainly does that for us, forgives us of our sins. But all those things that hold us bound, all those things that capture us, enslave us, from them we are set free in this meal. Because Christ has gone to the cross for us. And in eating and drinking, we are set free becoming new members of his kingdom, people, God's people. And so as we eat and as we drink, we do so remembering that we've been called into this new relationship, this new covenant. And as Jesus says, he will not drink it anew until he drinks it new in the kingdom of God. We are invited to join that kingdom that Christ is building in our world. As we eat and as we drink, he comes to meet us and to invite us to join him in the kingdom that he is growing, that we might live as forgiven people, set free from all that controls, all that manages us, all that enslaves us. Thanks be to God that we have been set free. Thanks be to God that we have this meal in which we join Jesus Christ in his kingdom. Amen. Let us pray. God of love, it's because of your immense love for us that you stooped to be our servant and willingly suffered to give us life. For that love, we give you thanks. We also praise you for the way that love is shown in creation, in our community, in this church, in our lives, in the events of Holy Week. God of love, you have given us a new command to love each other. Help us to show that love in our care for creation, to show that love to the nations of the world, to the people of this nation and its leaders, to show that love in this community, to show that love through the church throughout the world, and through the local church in its community and its ministry. Help us to show that love to people in particular need who we mention before you now in this silence. In all our thoughts and actions, may we be your servants and reflect your love. We pray this in the name of your servant Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever. Amen. So, if you want to get your bread and cup, we are going to eat and drink together, remembering the love that Christ has for us, having called us to be his people. And he invites all who want to join his kingdom to eat and to drink, to celebrate. Let us pray. O holy God, Father, almighty creator of heaven and earth, with joy we give you thanks and praise. Your beloved Son came as a servant to wash away our pride and to feed us with the bread of life. We thank you for inviting us to feast with him who died for us and who calls us to serve each other in love. We bless you for creating the whole world, for your promises to your people Israel, and for the life we know in Jesus Christ, your Son. Born of Mary, he shares our life. Eating with sinners, he welcomes us. Leading his followers, he guides us. Dying on the cross, he rescues us. Risen from the dead, he gives us new life. With thanksgiving, we take this bread and this cup and proclaim his death and resurrection. Receive our sacrifice of praise. Send to us your Holy Spirit, that this meal may be holy and that your people may become one. Unite us in faith, inspire us to love, encourage us with hope, that we may receive Christ as he comes to us in this holy banquet. We praise you, Almighty Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord Jesus, on that night, as the meal was ending, took bread, he blessed it and he broke it. He gave to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this, remembering me." So take a piece of the bread or the cracker or whatever you have, that we may eat together, for this is the bread of life. And then Jesus took the cup. He said, "This cup is a sign of the new covenant, the new relationship between God and human beings. Every time you drink, so drink of it, remembering me and my love for you, remembering the kingdom that is coming." Again, take the water or juice or whatever you have, for this is the cup of salvation. Drink in celebration. Let us pray. O God, you so greatly loved us, so long sought us, and so mercifully redeemed us. Give us grace that in everything we may yield our lives, our wills, and our works, a continual thank offering to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Pain. I won't trade it for any.